Well, we're heading to the supply house to get a blower wheel. I finally got it off of the shaft, and it's the kind that usually is not in this situation condition. Usually you can hold the blower wheel and turn the shaft, but the hub itself separated itself from the blade, so when you turn the shaft, the hub turns. So I had to cut some of the blades to get a pair of channel locks in from the side to hold the hub and then be able to turn the shaft itself. And thank goodness that a little bit of WD-40 sitting for an hour, the motor just about practically just fell out by itself. I turned it a few times, picked the whole thing up, shook it a little bit, and the motor just came right out. But let's go get this motor, this blade. And it was kind of really expensive, and they don't know why it was indicating being so expensive. They gave me a good price on it, but I got the old one with me, and I'm going to take it just to be sure that it's the right one, because they hesitant of knowing if it's the right one or not. They just wonder why the price was as high as it is, that it is. Normally they're somewhere around, you know, half of the price of what it actually shows in the system. So I'm going to bring this one and lay it side by side just to be sure that it's the right one. Still don't know why the price on it, but we'll see. Well, we have the blower assembly back together with a new wheel. And they had a bolt that just snapped, this one right here. So I had to come up a way to make that actually stay in there. So this is what it's supposed to be, and this is what we got. Took a piece of tubing and put in there as a sleeve. And then I got a washer sitting there that flattened on top of it. Then I put two nuts on it to lock each other down so it won't vibrate off or anything, which I doubt if it would, if just one, but didn't want to take the chance. But she's back together. And now it's time to go put it back in. All right, we got the blower assembly all put back together. I'm heading out now to go put all that back in. I finally got a response back from them, let me know they are home. My coffee shop I used to go to is reopened today since the hurricane we had. And I'm going to go get me a cup of coffee because I got a long drive ahead of me to go put this back in. I'll see you when I get there putting the blower assembly back in. It's one of the easiest ones I ever had to put in. You'll see why I say that when I show you how easy it is to put this blower in. All right, we got the motor and assembly and everything back in. Like I was saying, it's real easy. You just take the whole assembly, you take one panel off and open up, disconnect these limit switches here, disconnect wires, which I got them all marked 1 through 5. You take out this screw, you take this screw out, this whole thing just slides out. I wish they still make them that way. Won't be long before that coil might be springing a leak. But I think this is the last winter that they're going to actually have the unit here. They're thinking about changing it out. It's been a long time since I worked on this, for many, many years. Changed the heat exchanger in this one. Burners twice. I don't think I ever changed the outdoor motor. I can't remember. I might have. But I'm going to go and turn it on and see if all good. All right, we got fan. Well, she's definitely pulling some air in there now. All right, I'm gonna put this panel on and let them know that she's running. All right, she's back together just to show how old this unit is. Let's see if we can get a good capture of this here. Right there. 11 of 96. There's the serial number. There's the model number. Old unit, but still going. If anything else goes wrong with it, it's going to be a major most thing, most likely, because it could be compressor or that coil, either one. I know it's not going to be the heat exchanger, most likely, because it's been less than 10 years since it's been changed. New burners, less than 2 years old. So we'll see how long it lasts, but I think they're talking about changing this out to electric, because they said gas is just getting too expensive. So I'm going home.